Coming up, we have Stanley Unwin and the funniest videos in town. Rod's dad. But Stanley Unwin, the man behind the puppet, here in the studio. The series is out on video, so Stanley, tell us all about it. Were you a bit surprised? It was a bit of a walk down memory lane when they announced that this video was coming out.
Yes, I was agreeably surprised because it was such fun making it, you know. How it all started was we were doing the post-singing on Chitty Chitty Bang Bang, you know, because I won't go too much into that because that's another funny story. But my agent, who happened to be at the studios at Pinewood, said, "Stanley, I want you to meet Gerry Anderson. He's got an idea for using you in a puppet series."
Now, you didn't take it as a sort of sore reflection of your acting talents that the puppet was to do the main bit of the work?
No, not at all, because I don't consider myself a very good actor, you know.
Oh.
No, I don't think, I have to say this. You see, I'm a little bit wooden. That helps with puppets, of course.
The series is very reminiscent of its time, definitely. And do you think that its value is as a curio now, or do you think that it'll find new fans?
I think it'll probably find new fans. You see, the interest in the old Model T Ford, you know, two gears, driving to London Airport,
You flew around in that, didn't you?
I drove it into London Airport, and Rolls Royce would come along and their drivers would look benignly over at me and say, "Ah, deep joy there," you know, and on would go Tin Liz. Only brakes on the rear wheels, you know. More folly.
Tricky stuff.
Yeah, it was.
And were those the only bits that you actually filmed of you personally? The bits that wasn't the puppet bit, was it?
No. Oh, I used to visit big buildings and meet potential spies, you know, try and weigh them up and cut them down to size. By the way, this involves the minimizer. Do you know about the minimizer?
I do indeed. I've watched the series.
Yes. Well, that minimizer, Professor Humboldt, you see. And it enabled me, if there's somebody I didn't like, a big, robust man who's flaunting the world, I would say, "Press the butt low, titty, titty, by low," and down he'd go, treated about 3 foot long, kicking him up the bum loader.
I wouldn't mind you using it on me, but just not to shrink my height, but just my size.
Do you think we deep proportion, Venus modify? Measurements, you know, I can see that.
Yes, Matthew, I'm bang on schedule.
I wanted to talk to you a bit about the Unwinnies. Was that one of the main reasons that they asked you to become involved in the series? They wanted the Unwinnies to be a part of the script?
As an estate agent, I mean a spy, as a spagent, Her Majesty's agent, spy agent, I had to be able to confuse people as well, you see. So I think Gerry thought that was probably a good idea, so that if I was in difficulty, I could talk my way out of it, perhaps.
You're not obliged to say anything unless you wish to do so, but what you say may be put into writing and used in evidence.
Ah, yes. Righty scribbly in your bookery. All uttery words, speed of your pen slowed, must deceive my eye bold.
I didn't quite catch that, sir.
Ah, Partlow, I'll explain to you. Now, Matthew, my gardener, is deep joy with green fingers in the garbage, you understand.
I see.
Yes. Well, now, we've got this urgent mission for the bishop. Do you understand for the bishop of that?
Right.
You do? Right. Well, unfortunately, Matthew is trapped in the engines all rotating most.
Rotating most?
Yes, that's the rotating engine bold. You spell it E-I-N-G, hengy, hengy, bold. Right. Now, this does a... Engy bold.
Engy bold.
Correct.
Now, you've also been looking at some new comedy videos that are out. You've looked at Roseanne Barr, I think, and at Rowan Atkinson and at Frank Skinner's tape. Which was your favourite out of the three?
Well, out of the three, I think... I think Roseanne, not so much the expletive of the word that you follow it through and that, but she will say something rather nice about making love. She'll say, "If the whole world hold hands, they can't press the nuclear button." So I say, "Deep joy, kissy, cuddle, no pressy, bidden, tuttle, over, follow, then blow you up in the early morning."
But seriously, folks, I have been in show business a long time, and you people are without a doubt the finest audience I have ever had the privilege of performing in front of. And this place, casino name here. is the greatest casino in the world, and Tom Arnold is hung like a horse.
You mentioned the others, Frank Skinner?
Frank Skinner and Rowan.
Yes, Frank was a little toilet paper thing. There was a joke about a number of toilet sheets. Daddy, headmaster, you can't use more than 6 sheets, you see. And he got a bit annoyed about that. It took me back to school, you see. So I thought, well, carefold paper, trotty trotty to the toilet box. And there's a thing, you see. Oh, yes.
How do you think that the English humour compared with the American, i.e. say Rowan versus Roseanne?
Not easy to judge that. I think the sort of languages, I saw the Rowan thing which he did in, it was in Brooklyn, wasn't it? In Boston, mm-hmm. I think, Boston. Mm-hmm, Boston. He seemed to have a very good audience. Mm. Mind you, I think with an which I might call a semi-captive audience, to say the least of it, and where they've got a little drop of tilty elbow, this gives a heightened feeling for the Thunder Mole, and they fall in line with a little chuckle and wobble of the epiglottis, and I think they rather enjoy it.
Well, thank you very, very much, Stanley Unwin. Thank you for coming in, and it's been a pleasure to meet you.
Joyful to meet you, and kissy hand bold.
Now, you're all here...